Yes, that's right, it's Joe here for Joyrider TV, and yes, that's right, this is a Hobie 16. Yesterday I had the pleasure of sailing this boat with Phil in what can only be described as champagne plus conditions, probably about 25 knots in the gusts, so it should have been absolutely epic. But unfortunately, there was one thing, or actually more accurately, two things which held us back, and those were the rudders. So first, the port side rudder, which will have affected us more on the way out. So if I see if the rake at the stock, it's only coming back, like I would say half a little finger, but that half a little finger at the stock is amplified down the length of the rudder blade, which means the tip of the blade is actually probably moving backwards about an inch, which is quite significant when you're sailing at speed. The second thing that we're looking at is any sideways play. So, yeah, that's pretty significant. Whoa, yeah, so that's about an inch of sideways play on there as well. So if the rudder rake isn't correct and it comes back a bit, when you're sailing fast, that is just gonna feel like the rudders are heavy and you've got a lot of windward or weather helm all of the time, which means you have to be pulling on the stick all of the time to keep the boat even going in a straight line. Now, this sideways movement with the rudder blade, if you've got that, what that is going to create is rudder stall at speed. Now, what rudder stall is when you're going fast and this is pushing sideways, it's going to feel like you just totally lose grip at the back of the boat because we get an air pocket around the rudder blade, which means the rudders aren't gripping. And the feeling you get on the boat is kind of like someone's thrown a bucket off the back of the boat and suddenly the brakes are on and the steering doesn't work. Rudder rake a bit worse on this side, and then the play side to side, yeah, maybe slightly less. So the rudders are off, and looking at the rudder stocks, these are extremely worn. And one of the problems is these holes here, where the cam pins go, they're so worn that the pin can't actually stay in anymore, regardless of whether you make it a bit bigger or smaller, because it has to be small enough to go through the centre of the cam. Where the bushing goes, this is really worn as well. So even the bushing is moving. The hole where the bolt goes is really worn. These castings are actually 10 years old, which in the grand scheme of things isn't very old, but this boat has been used so much in heavy wind. These would be the equivalent of probably 50-year-old rudder stocks. So it's time for an upgrade. It's Christmas for H3 on the Wild Wind Beach, so I just need to fit these with all of the parts. Because when they come supplied, they're completely bare. So we've got the new cams, the new Delrin screws, springs, not new, plungers, used, the pin for the cam. Okay, so there we go. The new rudders are on. They're not new rudders, just new rudder stocks. So that should work a whole lot better now. Yeah, that feels solid. Can't wait to take it out for another run and see how it compares. Thanks for watching. I'll be back soon with some more on Joyrider TV. Thank you very much.